The big story in the American stock market yesterday was the steep fall of Apple. It lost 6% and it's down now more than 20% since the top in the end of September. One of the reasons for Apple's steep fall is that Nokia has joined forces with a Chinese, big Chinese company regarding the Chinese market, and they would then give Apple a competition regarding smartphones. The fiscal cliff is still in the focus. Obama yesterday met with business leaders in Washington. He stressed very strongly that he is ready for a compromise if the Republicans can consider then to have tax increases for the very rich and wealthy Americans. If this is the situation, we can reach an agreement within 1 week, Mr. Obama stated. On the currency front, the euro, US dollar, is stable around 130-150. It was falling down a little bit from the peak on Wednesday, 131-27, due to a disappointing Spanish bond auction. That brought, you could say, the strongest optimist back to realities, and it was a steep reminder about the fiscal health both in Spain and inside the Eurozone. Yen is also weaker this morning. That has a positive effect on the Japanese Nikkei, which continues up, and Asian stock markets were this morning trading higher than they have done for several months. This is based on optimism on Obama's last statement indicating a possibility for a compromise with the Republicans. Oil prices are have been going down since yesterday. It's now trading a little bit below $109 a barrel, and gold prices are also still under pressure, and it tested the lowest level for the last week yesterday in trade in the United States, 1685, and it has recovered a little bit, but still it seems that we have gold on its way down. I wish all traders a very good trading day from United World Capital and Cyprus.